Now, there's a new book out, and I'm halfway through it. It's called Amateur Hour, Kamala Harris in the White House. It's written by Charlie Spiering. He's a political reporter, former White House correspondent for Breitbart News, conservative operation. He joins us now from Washington, D.C. So from what I'm getting out of your book, and it's not a hatchet, y'all, I thought it would be, because you're a conservative guy, and I don't know any conservatives who really have much use for Kamala Harris, but you lay out pretty much how she has conducted herself in the public arena, from California politics all the way to Washington. From what I'm getting, and correct me if I'm wrong, because I haven't finished the whole book, Kamala Harris is basically a machine politician. She attached herself to powerful people in the California Democratic Party, Willie Brown, former mayor of San Francisco and big shot in Sacramento. And she kind of rose up through the patronage system, attorney general, senator, but she's never really done anything. Or if she has, I haven't gotten to it yet in your book. Am I wrong? Am I missing a point here?
That's right, Bill. You really hit the nail on the head. In fact, in my research, one of the earliest critiques of Kamala Harris was from you yourself on your own show, where you pointed out how police officers were arresting women for prosecution, but Kamala Harris refused to prosecute, so leaving all their work into the dust. This is the kind of person she was. She did not take any controversial or any serious reform proposals. She kind of just rode along, made the elites happy, and kept rising through the ranks of California politics. When you run in a one-party town, you're not running to convince voters to vote for you. You're basically running to keep the elites impressed, to convince the elites that you deserve a place on the national stage. And that's how she rose through the ranks and ultimately becoming senator and then finally our vice president.
Well, like her boss, Joe Biden, she doesn't seem to have any core beliefs. At one time in California, she was aggressively prosecuting marijuana dealers. Okay, but now she doesn't want to do that. She was always pro-choice. She was always an abortion person. But early on, she wasn't a woman, hear me roar. She was subservient to men. It doesn't look like she has any core belief system other than I want to get power, and I'm going to do what I have to do to get it.
Absolutely. When she first ran for president, she kind of ran into that wall of being very, so really struggling to explain exactly what she believed and really trying to coordinate her different positions on different issues. And she definitely had an issue going into the campaign. And we saw that during the debates. We saw that as she tried to attack Joe Biden on issues of race. But without any sincere belief, without any sincere core, she failed to impress voters on the national stage.
Yeah. And I mean, look, if she in the debate says to Biden, hey, you are a racist, because little girls like me, you remember the quote, were forced to do these things and we shouldn't have been forced to do them. And you were behind that. And then she says, oh, yeah, but now I want to be vice president. You go, wait, you should be running away from this guy. In the larger picture, if Joe Biden wins re-election, because she's going to be on the ticket. They're not going to boot Kamala Harris off because they can't, because she fills all the boxes for the ethnicity, the DEI, all of that. She can't boot her off. Then you're actually, because I don't think Biden, if he's reelected, is going to make 4 years. My God, the guy's got early dementia now. So you're really voting for her for president.
That's right. Absolutely. Kamala Harris could very easily become the 47th president of the United States. And that's kind of why I wrote the book. Who is this woman? How did she get so high up in politics to be a heartbeat away from the presidency as it is? You know, we didn't have to worry about that so much with vice presidents like Al Gore, because, you know, Bill Clinton was relatively healthy. So it's important to understand who this person is beyond the word salads, beyond the insecurities and inability to communicate. So we're very much looking at the possibility of a President Kamala Harris, who has never run for president on her own, run a successful presidential candidate campaign on her own without making and becoming the next president.
I would assume she would be almost like Biden, a captive of the far left, progressive left, would tell her pretty much what to do and she would do it. Would I be wrong?
No, absolutely. The problem is that Team Biden has a very strong, very powerful cohort who are advising him and telling him what to do. But Kamala has a lot of anger towards that team. She feels like she's been sidelined by that team. She feels like she's been put in bad situations because of that team. And when she does ultimately take power, she's going to anger a lot of Democrats and make them really upset as she sort of clears house and installs her own team.
So you really believe that she has a deep resentment toward the Biden White House, not just passive aggressive, that she kind of like want to settle some scores?
Yeah, I think that, you know, Biden famously wanted a buddy presidential candidate who he could lunch with frequently. You noted that she's having lunch with him today. There were huge stretches where they didn't even meet up or have lunch at all. And there was definitely, especially during the chaos on the border, she was not happy. I report in the book, she was not happy with having that role thrust upon her. She repeatedly corrected him in person, in public, in front of him, that she was not handling the border crisis. She was only in charge of root causes. So I really think that she feels that she had to protect her political brand from Biden, and she really has no respect for Biden at this point at all.
There is a rumor that Biden wanted Whitmer, the governor of Michigan. Did you check that out?
Yes, absolutely. He definitely preferred Whitmer. He viewed her as a very helpful person, someone who is plain spoken, someone who is committed to infrastructure. If you remember her campaign, she won on the idea of just fix the damn roads. You know, Biden's an infrastructure person. That really resonated with him. But it came at the same time that the whole country was on fire with the George Floyd riots. And even Whitmer herself tried to take herself out of the running for vice president, but Biden urged her to stay in. Ultimately, though, his team and former President Obama convinced him that it was critical to have a woman of color on the ticket if they were going to put the Obama coalition back together in 2020.
All right. Charlie, we appreciate the book again is Amateur Hour, Kamala Harris in the White House. Good luck with it. Hope people check it out.